Try the newest, cheapest, and fastest delivery in Express a Service. Introducing Moto Express PH. You can now leave your shopping and delivery needs with us without much exposure and interaction to people outside. Mapa grocery items, medicines, foods, and other essentials and halal certified products, kami na ang mamimili at maghahatid sa'yo. Sinisigurado na ligtas, in good and quality condition ang mga pabili o orders sa delivery service na iyong ia-avail. Para sa maayos at mabilis na delivery at order mo, ipamoto mo na. Download Moto Express PH app through Google Play that is built to deliver beyond your expectation. Tara na dito sa Moto Express. Dahil moto mo to.
Hi everybody, it's Monday again. Assalamualaikum and very good morning to all of you. So today is our second episode of Halal Shopping TV, and then we will present about a product from Malaysia. So I'm Al-Fakir from Malaysia, will become your host for today. And today actually, I was in my shop. We call it as a Sabah Halal Market. In this shop, we have collect all product from Sabah, and also we try to focus to help our entrepreneur to get halal after this. Okay, so for today, we will have our co-host and then one guest from Kota Kinabalu, Sabah. We will introduce after this. And today, actually, is the 3rd of May 2021. I was live from Sandakan, Sabah. And then we still have, now it's still Ramadan, about another a few weeks that we have finished, and we will have a Hari Raya Aidilfitri. Okay, selamat pagi semua kepada semua penonton-penonton tak kira di Malaysia, Filipin. Saya Al-Fakir akan menghostkan rancangan berbentuk shopping ataupun dipanggil Halal Shopping TV yang dibawa khas daripada Filipin. Dan program ini khas ditujukan kepada semua entrepreneur ataupun usahawan-usahawan di Malaysia untuk memperkenalkan produk anda di Halal TV ini, yang mana akan ditonton oleh ramai usahawan dan juga penonton yang rata-rata di Filipin. Okay, so for today, I'm very lucky. I wish my co-host, Mrs. Ruby. Last week, in the first episode, already present her product, and today become as my co-host to manage this Halal Shopping TV for Malaysia edition. So let's welcome Mrs. Ruby. Mrs. Ruby, hi.
Hidup.
Oh, okay. Okay, now we are in the live with our guest. Assalamualaikum, Puan Raimas.
Waalaikumsalam.
Yeah. Okay.
Waalaikumsalam.
Yeah, okay. So you are now in the car driving. Okay. We are waiting from my co-host, Mrs. Ruby. Mrs. Ruby. Puan Raimas.
Yeah.
Okay, can you focus your camera, I mean your okay. So today is our session. Our Halal TV. So are you ready to present your product or you are waiting? So
your product model. Melo. Hello, Cik. Hello.
We are in the show right now. We are live in Halal Shopping TV.
Okay. What now, Puan Raimas, now is he still driving?
Okay. Okay, let's...
Saya mata kali dah mana sebelah. Panu grup itu tepi. Kau sambil tepi.
How about Mr. Subi? Are you there?
Panu jelas pun. Okay.
Okay.
Kau sambil tepi lagi Subi itu.
Okey Kak, so sekarang kita bersama dalam Halal Shopping TV. So mungkin we are using English version, so it's okay. I think my co-host will join us together. We become as a translate okay. Your only. Let's talk about your product now. So
okay, cerita produk awak. Yeah.
So what is your product, Mrs. Raimas? I know that you have a product from a seafood.
Okay, sir. Now, Puan Raimas, she want to sharing about her product, and then after that, she just translate it to the foundation.
Yeah. Okay, let's introduce you have a slide.
Okay. Now Puan Raimas introduce Malay language.
Yeah, it's okay.
And then after that just translate it in English language.
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay.
Ayan dito ba?
Nakaw lah ba?
Okay, my name is saya penguasa keropok Lekor. Dan saya salah satu pemenang 2019 dalam bidang lekor dan ini adalah lekor saya.
Tambah okay. Continue.
Tangan. Dah aku pandai bang apa yang aku mau cakap. Yang ini produk saya. Bang tak nampak. Yang ini produk saya.
Ya, yeah, okay.
Cakap.
Keropok lekor kan?
Okay. Iya, keropok lekor.
Yeah, it's a frozen food. So.
Iya.
So what is apa yang menarik tentang produk agak?
Menarik tentang produk saya pada 2019. Saya telah menyertai macam pertandingan untuk merebut dana kerajaan lah. Dan saya alhamdulillah lekor saya terpilih untuk memenangi dana itu.
Okay, you have get a special grant from our government. So I think it's a good product from your side. Okay, so what is the ingredient that are you using in this product?
Bahan-bahan mentah. Saya menggunakan ikan segar, ikan terisi, ikan segar, tepung ubi, garam, telur, lemak sayur, dan sebagainya lah. Dan rasa lekor saya itu tidak seperti orang lain. Rasa lekor saya lembut, walaupun dia sejuk. Dia tak liat, tak macam yang lain-lain yang berada di pasaran.
So your unique is your product is more to the soft. Yeah. So you have a sample of your product right now? Ada contoh?
Contoh tu saya tak dapat.
I forgot to bring the sample.
Iya, saya tak dapat sediakan sebab saya ada mesyuarat di tempat lain. Jadi produk itu saya tak dapat bawa pada hari ini.
Okay. So do you have any slide to present to share with us? Ada apa?
Okay, bang. Pegang dulu, bang. Ya.
Boleh.
Tangan berguna.
Ada apa-apa yang lain lagi orang nak cakap?
Okay.
Cakap tentang apa-apa. Tidak boleh konsentrasi bagi kita kalau macam ini.
Saya cuma ada, cuma tak nampak lah bang. Tak nampak. Susah saya tunjuk bang di dalam handphone saya, di dalam laptop saya.
Okay. Okay. Sorry, we talk of our guest is very busy right now. So I think before that, I think please welcome Mrs. Ruby to become my co-host. Mrs. Ruby, are you there?
Hello, assalamualaikum everyone. Yes, yeah. Assalamualaikum everyone. So yes. Magandang umaga sa inyong lahat po, those who are joining our live streaming for today.
Okay.
Yes.
So thank you very much. Yeah.
Yes. You're welcome. Welcome. Yes. Yeah. So just now, I just saw. Actually, we have a guest, right? Which is Mrs. Raimas with us on the show. So what we are doing here is just we are sharing, or we are trying to bring in, you know, like into a global market, especially for those like local products, right? Assalamualaikum. Yeah. Assalamualaikum Puan Raimas.
Iya, waalaikumsalam. Yeah. Selamat berpuasa.
Puan Raimas.
Selamat ya, saya.
Jangan kelantabur, relax. It's okay. Just be focus. Kita boleh it's a live show. So hopefully you can focus. So before that tenang-tenang saya, kita akan share satu video. Because this video I want to share because Kak Raimas is from KK, is it? Daripada
dari Kota KK. Kinabalu. Ha, yeah. Puan Raimas so dari KK kan?
Yeah, KK. So sekarang ni kita bersiaran. We are in Halal Shopping TV, which Global Finance TV 169 yang berpekalan di Filipina. So I think I want to share one video. What is in our Kota Kinabalu, we have a Philippine market and very famous, I think. So
yes.
I want to show to all of you because before we go to our product for today, I want to show because our product today is related to more to the fish, I think. It's
fish. Produk kita lebih kepada ikan, right?
Yeah, for today. So I try to show first and then we watch together because this very famous in Kota Kinabalu.
Exactly.
And then I think everybody who travel in Sabah or Kota Kinabalu, mostly they are come to this what we call a Filipino market in Kota Kinabalu. Okay, next video. Is it sound okay?
Hai, aku sekarang berada dekat Filipina. makin dekat Kota Kinabalu, Sabah.
Pertanyaan nombor
apa yang ada dekat dalam supermarket ni?
It's an open market, I think. It's an open market and it open daily basis, every day. And then the most, I think, popular is a seafood. Yes, this is seafood. There's a grilled seafood. I think Filipino like this. We try to promote also, I think, in a Halal Shopping TV, even it's in terms of halal tourism. Okay.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Have you been there in this Filipino market, Mrs. Ruby?
Yeah, I always here because actually it's just near to my place. It's near to my place. And you know what? The food are awesome. You know, all are fresh. With fresh, the, you know, the price. The price is also very reasonable and very affordable.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think I'm quite far from there. I'm from Pandakan. But actually, when I go there, you go to Kota Kinabalu.
Yes, you maybe, should try
maybe
actually.
This week, this week, I don't know, I have planned to go there. So,
but I think at the moment they are closed during this like CMCO. Yeah, it's closed, yep.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So there are many variety of foods here.
Exactly, especially for us, the fresh and the seafood.
Yes.
Yeah, so you know what, this place is actually like a well-known among the tourists you know, all over in the Malaysia.
Yes.
Yeah, so a lot of tourists went here. Before the COVID, is actually it's a really like a famous place. It's kind of a hot spot in Kota Kinabalu as well.
Yes, I think so. Mm-hmm. So, Puan Rahimah, are you there still? Have you been there? Puan Rahimah, Mr. Puan Rahimah. Sorry. I have to spell Rahimah.
Rahimah.
Okay, let's start again. I mean, stop sharing first. Okay, I believe that this Filipino market is one of the example. Example is integrated is our Malaysia and also Philippines. So that's why I think this show also have an opportunity to us to entrepreneur like Puan Rahimah, Puan Ruby to take a part of this show to show off your product. So
exactly, it's a good platform.
Yes, yeah, good. Yeah. This is the second episode, but we believe that we still are new. We have to prepare more before.
Exactly.
Hopefully, we can do a daily basis every Monday to Friday. So I try.
Yeah, we can bring more. Actually, we can bring more guests, especially you know, like a small entrepreneur in Sabah, especially right. So macam as we are talking about right now, I mean right now we are talking about halal food, you know, especially dengan Puan Rahimah. Okay, kita bersiaran bersama dengan Puan Rahimah, right? Assalamualaikum Puan Rahimah. So okay, saya rasa kita memandangkan kita ramai, I mean kita cuba berkongsi dengan orang ramai, okay, produk Puan Rahimah di luar sana. So maybe Puan Rahimah boleh bercakap dalam bahasa Melayu, okay? Insyaallah kami, saya dan Encik Fakir akan cuba translate supaya you know lebih ramai orang, okay, lebih ramai orang di luar sana, okay, yang akan lebih tahu, okay, tahu berkenaan dengan produk Puan Rahimah.
Boleh, Puan Rahimah?
Boleh.
So, di belakang saya adalah banyak produk yang saya banyak tempatan. Ada juga kita lihat di sini exactly Sabah tea produk.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Maybe, that's well-known. That is the
one
famous
tea. One more thing. We are trying to focus on for the micro-entrepreneur first in Sabah.
Okay.
So, that's why we believe that it's this. Okay, Puan Rahimah, you start with your product. You present based on your, actually you just present what you want to.
Okay, Puan Raimas. Okay, Puan Raimas macam ni. Puan Raimas cuba. Yes, okay, Puan Raimas just terangkan kepada kita punya penonton di luar sana. InsyaAllah saya akan bantu untuk translate. Puan Raimas, okay. Setakat ini produk Puan Raimas dipasarkan di mana? Okay, macam mana channel pengagihan produk Puan Raimas tu di Sabah? Okay.
Okay. Setakat ini saya punya keropok lekor berada di beberapa supermarket dan mini-mini market. Yang begitulah. Macam beberapa supermarket yang besar tu, saya telah tempatkan keropok lekor saya di sana lah.
Alright, so hello everyone. According to Mrs. Raimas, okay, she is distributing her product, especially in Sabah. She distributes through a channel like a supermarket, you know. So in a, she is trying to actually to distribute like a more wide, you know, the market, because we understand that the market for her product is actually quite like a big, you know. So what we know is actually according to Mrs. Raimas, okay, macam, you know, her product is one of the winner, okay, for the local entrepreneur, right, Mr. Fakir?
Yes.
Yeah, she won entrepreneurship, right, and she got a grant for the, you know, the a finance from the government to support her business as well. So that's how good the government here. I mean, they are supporting like a, especially like a small entrepreneur to grow their business as well, right?
Yes.
Okay, so setakat ini, okay, macam mana dengan proses macam Puan Raimas punya produk ni kan? So proses pengeluaran dia macam mana tu? I mean, adakah dikilang ataupun masih berasaskan homemade?
Macam mana tu?
Okay, macam produk Puan Raimas ni kan? Okay, Puan Raimas
kejap,
dia
saya
punya.
Saya suruh sampai di rumah. Buka dulu kita. Okay. Okay, ada bagus sikit. Sekejap.
Tak apa Kak, busy tak apa. Orang usahawan memang selalu begitu sibuk.
Betul, betul.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, macam mana tu?
Memahami. Saya nak show video berkenaan dengan keropok lekor, tapi kalau kalau Kak memang dah ada produk lagi bagus.
Ya, betul.
Okay.
Ya,
sebab saya tak ada. Tuan, yang saya bagi tu slide tak ada kah dengan tuan?
Okay, tak apa. Puan present tu nanti saya akan share. Saya cuba share.
Ya, kalau ada yang saya bagi tu.
Okay, Puan teruskan menjawab soalan-soalan daripada Mrs. Ruby. Berkenaan dengan
macam mana tadi tu Ruby?
Okay, begini. Kita mau terangkan kepada apa ni penonton di luar sana. Ya, penonton di luar sana. Proses pengeluaran, okay, proses pengeluaran produk Puan Raimas. So, setakat ini adakah dia mati berasaskan macam homemade or sudah ada kilang or mini kilang or whatsoever?
Masih lagi berasaskan homemade.
Okay, alright.
Homemade lah, tapi insyaAllah dalam proses saya akan menempatkan dia di kilang.
Alright,
dan okay. Sekarang pun dalam proses, okay. Lagipun kerajaan Sabah membantu kami untuk mendapatkan sijil halal dan mesti. Jadi sekarang itu ke arah itu.
Alright, so okay everyone. So according to Puan Raimas, okay, Mrs. Raimas is actually she at the moment her product is produced like a still a homemade basis. So but in the process of processing into a small factory, which is the government have been supported her, you know, to produce her product more like a high volume, you know, like just to support the demand of the market, right, Mr. Fakir?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a good opportunity for all the entrepreneurs to because our government is very committed to help
exactly
entrepreneur to develop the product. So I think one of the good thing is in terms of a halal certification. In our show, halal is a global. When our halal Jakim is one of the top, in the world.
Exactly.
I think, even you are as a micro entrepreneur, but I believe that one time that when your product going into the global market, this halal certification must be
It's a must. Yes. So we understand. We understand that the market actually like we cannot bring out our product into an international market. You know, kita punya fokus sekarang Puan Raimas is actually kita cuba untuk kembangkan. Okay, kita cuba kembangkan. Kita cuba pasarkan. Okay, produk lokal kita kepada pasaran antarabangsa, especially in Asian country. Because kita cuba untuk mewujudkan lebih banyak lagi produk halal because as a Muslim it's a kind of our responsible to provide halal food for our Muslim brother and sister, right? So kita cuba ketengahkan produk halal, okay, and dalam masa yang sama kita cuba untuk kembangkan dan membantu usahawan-usahawan kecil, okay, usahawan-usahawan tempatan kita untuk memasarkan pasaran, I mean produk ke pasaran antarabangsa, right?
Okay, I try to share the slide giving from Mrs. Raimas. Hopefully, the connection is better. I try to share first.
Ini produk saya.
It's a really nice packaging anyway. It's really attractive. So because you know what, there's a lot of like a product which is same product, but what is most matter is actually the what we call the presentation. You know, the packaging is really important aside from the certification, right, Mr. Fakir?
Yes.
Kakak punya, I mean, kakak punya produk memang, I mean, dia punya packaging memang lain daripada yang lain lah. Biasa kita nampak produk Lekor, it's just like a blend saja, tidak banyak, tidak menarik sangat, right? Tidak terlalu menarik. So produk Puan Raimas is actually memang nampak sangat menarik. Right? So okay, yang kalau BKK.
Ini
produk IKS Sabah.
Yang suka makan Lekor, di mana saya berada buat promotion, dorang alhamdulillah coba dapatkan.
Okay, Puan Raimas, kita we want to share those who are in joining us, tune in with us, okay, in especially in Sabah. Okay, Puan Raimas, hari kalau di KK, di mana pasaraya mana, okay, boleh dapatkan produk Puan Raimas? Where we can get your product?
Seluruh Bataras.
Seluruh Bataras. Okay. For those who are joining us for today, okay, those who want to try Puan Raimas punya keropok lekor which is the best keropok lekor, you can grab it in Bataras market, right? Di Bataras kan, Puan Raimas?
Bataras Sabah.
All right, okay. So those who are joining or tuning in with us today, you can get a Puan Raimas product in all the branch, okay, of Bataras. Alright, so the brand, okay, brand dia Puan Raimas is Raimas, right? Puan Raimas.
Yes, saya.
So the product brand is actually Raimas. So penggemar-penggemar keropok lekor boleh dapatkan produk lekor Puan Raimas, okay? Jenama Puan Raimas, okay? Raimas keropok lekor. Alright. So aside from actually we are trying to promote your product, those who are out there, you know, we should help our local entrepreneur to support them, okay? Beli barangan lokal, okay, untuk support usahawan-usahawan kita. Okay, so maksud dia setakat ini di Bataras, seluruh Bataras KK saja kah or Sabah?
Ya, Sabah lah. Di KK Sabah lah.
So means, okay, everyone out there, so actually, product Puan Raimas, you can get her product in all Bataras branch in Sabah, right? So Puan Raimas, kita mau tahu Puan Raimas ada guna channel macam agent kah, stokis kah?
Oh ya, iya. Saya guna itu jugalah. Saya guna agent stokis tu untuk dorang ialah untuk saya kembangkan sebab sedikit bisnis saya.
Okay, so maksud dia apa ni? Orang-orang di luar sana, okay, penonton-penonton sana boleh menjana pendapatan.
Iya, which is
daripada kita macam sekarang Puan Rahimah dia lebih kepada B2B, dia supply kepada Bataras. Dia boleh jadikan agent menjual dekat kiosk. It's a B2B concept. Dan it's good because saya tahu kerupuk leko, or we call as a leko crunch, is a very famous in Sabah right now.
Yes,
and this is seafood dish. Maksudnya makanan ini ataupun produk ini adalah produk seafood. Biasanya adalah ikan kan, fish. Pernah ada kerupuk leko guna udang ke Kak Rimas? Boleh cuba ke udang atau benda
ada.
Lain?
Ada. Udang, sotong, cuma kos itu sangat tinggi.
Kos tinggi.
Kita gunakan sotong, kita guna ikan, gunakan udang, sotong tidak menjadi satu masalah. Cuma dia harga dia terlalu tinggi.
Okay, saya rasa ini pada saya lah. For me is saya bercakap sebagai pengguna, saya rasa kalau saya macam saya penggemar seafood, selain daripada ikan saya gemar kepada macam udang,
sotong.
Sotong actually doesn't really have a strong flavor. Dia punya rasa tidak terlalu susah untuk kita mengatakan ini rasa sotong because the flavor is not strong. Right?
Tapi udang
is really strong flavor. Dia punya rasa memang very strong. So I think sebab ada orang tidak makan ikan. Maksud dia ikan yang ada sesetengah jenis ikan orang tidak makan. You know, some people doesn't like to eat a certain types of fish, okay? So why not? Kenapa tidak Puan Raimas? Okay, cuba buat satu kelainan selain daripada kelompok lekor ikan, okay? And then cuba ketengahkan mungkin dalam I do believe in the business especially we can kita boleh perbagaikan the more variety of our product, right? Sebab kita tahu tidak semua orang suka, let's say not everyone like ikan basung, right? Tidak semua orang suka ikan basung, but some people also mungkin like a crab, you know, getam or udang, okay? So why not cuba ketengahkan? Maybe tidak terlalu banyak, maybe try the market, boleh cuba market pasaran macam mana. Even walaupun mungkin harga tu agak akan berbeza because kita faham. But I think adalah baik untuk kita cuba, we try to bagi pilihan kepada pengguna di luar sana it's a good idea actually.
Macam sekarang saya pun dalam proses membuat, sebab kebanyakannya ada je setengah-setengah customer tidak memakan seafood, contohnya ikan, udang, sotong. Saya juga buat keropok lekol berasaskan ayam.
Kerupuk
lekor ayam. Sebab kadang ada orang dia macam allergic ke makan ikan, seafood. Jadi kita buat pula dia lekor ayam. Kemudian kita perbagaikan dia macam black pepper, lekor black pepper. Ada buat itu juga dengan kita buat juga kerupuk lekor mozzarella cheese.
Okay. So setakat ini produk Puan Raimas berada di Bataras. Okay, kita faham. So maksud dia setiap jenis tu ada di Bataras.
Sebab saya kan mengikut tahap customer, kebanyakannya doang suka macam ikan. Tetapi yang itu kalau macam ada setengah-setengah customer yang dia cakap saya mau keropok lekor macam ayam, itu yang macam saya jadikan dia yang macam tertentu sahaja. Macam limited, lebih kurang limited edition lah begitu.
I see. So okay. So for those who are out there, actually, okay, according to Mrs. Raimas, okay, you can request the leko that she have. You can request if you don't like the seafood, okay, you can request macam a kind of a cracker in a chicken flavor, right? Can we? They do have like a with a black pepper chicken flavor, you know. So boleh order dengan Puan Raimas lah, maksud dia special request.
Yeah.
Tidak ada di pasaran lah, tidak masuk ke dalam pasaran makanan.
Ya, tidak ada. Tidak ada.
So setakat ini hanya produk ikan sahaja.
So
at the moment actually according to Mrs. Raimas, according to her actually at the moment the product that you can get actually only in a fish flavor, right Mr. Fakir? Okay, so anything you want to add on, Mr. Fakir? Okay, Puan Raimas, okay, kita mau tahu apa matlamat Puan Raimas, okay, selepas ini, apa matlamat Puan Raimas? Adakah setakat untuk memasarkan secara di Sabah saja ataupun sudah memasarkan di Semenanjung, okay, atau secara global ke ada apa matlamat yang Puan Raimas cuba capai dalam produk Puan Raimas ini sendiri?
Setakat ini yang saya mampu katakan, saya coba pasarkan dululah dia di Malaysia. Sebab untuk ke peringkat yang lebih jauh tu, saya perlukan strategik macam mana nak membawa jenama Raimas ini ke peringkat antarabangsa. Jadi saya memerlukan
maksudnya memang ada perancangan lah. So memang ada perancangan lah.
Insya Allah.
Baik kakak Cik Rukun, ini rancangan ni punya adalah rancangan antarabangsa kak eh. Kita berada walaupun di dalam sekarang zaman digital, memang kita tak perlu sangat kita terbang pergi sana pergi sini. Kita hanya banyak menggunakan digital dalam kita punya bisnes. Dan alhamdulillah hari ini kita bersama kat bawah walaupun kita ada dugaan-dugaan tertentu macam bila digital ni faham sajalah kadang bila kita punya internet apa semua kadang kita tak mampu untuk nak ni. Tapi tak apa, based on apa yang Kak present, kita di Malaysia memang kita faham lah tentang kerupuk leko. Asalnya ramai yang tahu kerupuk leko. Dan actually kerupuk leko bagi saya yang kita faham, yang biasa, yang famous kalau di Malaysia berada di Terengganu. Banyak so, orang
fresh yang mereka di Terengganu.
Macam-macam.
That is a paling famous lah. In Malaysia is actually from Terengganu, right? Kerupuk leko. It's a kind of fresh cracker from Terengganu.
Betul.
Right.
So when I come to Sabah, I think exactly dia ada kerupuk leko, but dia punya bentuk is macam empat segi yang dipotong-potong. Cuma rasanya tu macam lebih kepada macam sometimes saya rasa macam tepung lah mostly. Ikan ni kurang. Tapi lately ni ramai sudah yang belajar buat kerupuk leko. Mungkin usahawan daripada Mardi, mungkin kita punya agensi Mardi pun ada menyediakan program untuk
dia memang ada menyediakan macam saya oleh kerana saya Sabah terkenal dengan pengeluar ikan yang segar, sebab itu lekor saya itu disukai ramai sebab lekor saya itu rasanya lembut. Saya lebihkan dia ikan dibandingkan tepung walaupun saya crispy. Kalau lekor saya itu asli, macam dia lebih kepada 70% ikan, 30% tepung. Kalau dia crispy, 50-50. Cuma saya tidak mau meletakkan lekor saya itu lebih tepung dibandingkan ikan. Saya letak dia macam 60% ikan, 40% tepung. Sebab itu lekor saya, walaupun dia sejuk, dia masih lembut. Dan saya tak menggunakan ikan basung sebab kualiti saya punya lekor sepatutnya macam pasaran antarabangsa. Lekor saya itu ikan crispy. Jadi setengah-setengah orang bila dia memakan, dia macam terkejut. Kenapa rasa lekor saya itu macam seakan-akan rasa sotong. Sebab rahsianya pula saya menggunakan ikan kurisi, saya tidak menggunakan ikan basung. Itu kelebihan lekor saya.
Okay, so because you know what, a lot of people, a lot of like entrepreneur, they are using a kind of like ikan basung. Dia orang menggunakan ikan basung. Yeah. That's why the color itself is like a bit darker. Macam hitam or kelabu, the color is more into like a grey color. So keropok lekor Puan Raimas, dia lebih kepada color putih lah ya?
Iya. Sebab saya menggunakan ikan krisi.
I see.
Begitu, saya
So, bahkan kita dalam shopping ni, ramai orang nak shopping, even di Malaysia pun kita nak shopping juga. So, how about the price? Harga yang Kak tetapkan? Ada harga borong, ada harga pasaran.
Kalau harga pasaran untuk supermarket tu saya letak lain, untuk agent harganya lain.
Okay. So harga pasaran, market price. Harga pasaran di Bataras. Berapa harga pasaran untuk orang ramai
di Bataras? Okey, kalau di Bataras tu kalau di Bataras tu dalam RM13 saja. Kira macam berapa mampu miliklah, RM13.
Berapa kg? 1 kg.
Okey, yang 1 kg, yang 1 kg RM13, yang setengah kg tu dalam RM7 dorang pasarkan.
Okey.
Okey, 1 kg RM7.
Satu kg RM13. Setengah.
So maksud dia ada dua packaging. There is two packaging.
Yeah,
setengah kilo, okay, setengah kilo dan satu kilo. Alright, so there is two packaging, okay, for Mrs. Raimas product. One, the other one is a 500 kg, which is RM7, okay, for Malaysian market. And the other one is 1 kg for, which is worth of RM14 for Malaysia market, which is you can grab it today and at actually Bataras Hypermarket, right? Boleh didapatkan di pasaran. Alright, so bagi yang join or menonton, okay, menonton program TV Halal, okay, TV Halal Shopping Malaysia hari ini, okay, or anytime that you are watching this live streaming, okay, so boleh dapatkan produk Puan Raimas di Bataras, okay, produk membawa jenama Raimas, okay, Raimas keropok lekor, which is the best lekor in Sabah, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So,
Sandakan dah sampai ke? Sandakan dah sampai ke Bataras Sandakan?
Dia dalam proses. Sepatutnya dia proses di kesana. Cuma sepatutnya Tawau sempurna Sandakan. Cuma oleh kerana COVID, jadi perjalanan tu yang menyebabkan kita tidak dapat meneruskan usaha untuk menembus itu pasaran. Tapi memang di sana sepatutnya ada.
Okay, mau tanya
balik masalah kita ini COVID.
Okay, so macam mana
kan selalunya?
Okay, so Puan Raimas, kita mau tahu macam mana proses dia, maksudnya pengeluaran dan permintaan. Macam mana tu? Adakah dia seimbang ataupun sekarang ni dia sudah melebihi permintaan terlalu tinggi sampai tidak boleh pasarkan ke tempat lain?
Demand
sederhana. How's the demand? Sederhana. So means there are
alhamdulillah setiap hari saya ada permintaan. Sedangkan sekarang ni pun di mini kilang saya itu mereka telah mereka sedang memproses. Cuma sekarang saya berada di luar, jadi saya tak dapat tunjukkan di mana sekarang saya punya tim sedang memproses leko untuk satu tempahan lah macam dalam 300 kilo. Saya perlu keluarkan secepat mungkin.
Okay, so I think maybe in the future, mungkin pada masa-masa akan datang, okay, we can bring how the process, we can show to the, to our audience how's the process, you know, of any, product, local product. Mungkin insyaAllah masa-masa akan datang, kita boleh kongsikan, okay, proses, you know, proses, tidak kisahlah sama ada dia homemade base ataupun secara macam mini kilang. So maybe kita boleh kongsikan macam mana perjalanan bisnes-bisnes IKS ni kan, yang cuba because you know what, kita punya program ni, program Halal TV ni bersama dengan Global Finance TV, okay, 168. Actually kita punya matlamat utama, our main target is we are trying to, I mean, bring, you know, the local market into a global market, because we do believe like actually we are, kita cuba untuk ketengahkan untuk bawa ke pasaran global, okay, which is, that's why, sebab itu kita sekarang berkolaborasi bersama dengan Global TV Finas 168, right, Mr. Fakir?
Yes.
Also, we are collaborating, and also the motto, motto, what is that, sorry?
Moto Express. Delivery service.
So, delivery service. Actually, we are collaborating with you know, like a Moto service in Philippines, which is actually they are in Malaysia. They are like macam itu Food Panda, you know, Grab, you know, the More Fun, you know. So we are, kita berkolaborasi ya, Puan Raimas, untuk pengetahuan Puan Raimas, kita berkolaborasi dengan Moto Express Philippines. So maksud dia, insyaallah in the future, bila kita pasarkan produk, when we bring our product into a Philippines market, these are the channel who gonna distribute our product in the Philippines. Channel ni yang akan distribute produk Puan Raimas atau produk apa-apa produk dari Malaysia yang dibawa ke Philippines, okay? Diorang yang akan bantu untuk distribute kita punya produk kepada pelanggan kita di sana, insyaAllah.
Okay. So, kata-kata terakhir daripada Puan Raimas, sebab sebenarnya kita dah cukup time.
Saya ucapkan kepada kedua panel yang mengundang saya pada hari ini, terima kasih sangat banyak, sebab pada permulaan tadi ada sedikit macam terlengkabut sikit lah, sebab secara pribadi kali pertama lah yang macam melakukan sedemikian. Jadi itulah, saya berharap saya punya produk boleh memasuki pasaran Filipina lah. Sebab macam itu yang saya harapkan. Dan terima kasih banyak.
Thank you very much, Kak Raimas, to join us in Halal Shopping TV. So the second episode.
Terima kasih, Kak Raimas.
Don't forget to buy Mr. Sruby product. Yes, last week we have this product. I already get this yesterday.
Yeah, I've been sending.
Yes. Okay.
So for those,
thank you very much. See you again for next week. Right. With another guest. And thank you, Kak Raimas. And thank you very much. All the best. See you next week.
Bye-bye. Bye. Assalamualaikum.